Hello students, welcome to All You Scholar classes. So today I will be taking the part 3rd of chapter 11, that is light, shadow and reflection. In part 1 and part 2 I have discussed a lot. You can go and refer if you want to see the introduction of a light, the shadow. In the part 2 a detail is there. So today the topics which I am going to cover is, it's a very introductory only the introduction of light is there in this class. Okay, we need not to go in detail. So first we will see what is ray of light and what is beam of light. Okay, what is the definition of ray of light and a beam of light. Then we will see what is the obstacle, how an object comes in a path of a light. Then we will see rectilinear propagation. Okay, then pinhole camera, we will see how pinhole camera is used to see that light travels in a straight line. And a natural pinhole camera, what is a natural pinhole camera, we will see that also. Then we will see an introduction of mirror, the types of mirror, only introduction is there in your syllabus, concave, convex and plane mirror. Then we will see how reflection takes place by plane mirror. Okay, so these are the topics which I am going to cover today. So let's start with it. So a ray of light is a straight thin beam of light from a source of the object is called ray of light. Okay, a straight thin beam that of a light from where? From the source of an object. Suppose this is an object, a source, from the source of object, a straight thin beam of light that comes on the object, that falls from source to an object is called a ray of light. Okay, this is a source and this straight beam of light is falling on the object. Okay, so this is a straight thin beam of light. And if you see the beam of light is bunch of light traveling in a given direction. Okay, not only one, but a bunch of lights are traveling in a given direction. Okay, so ray of light definition is a straight thin beam of light from a source to an object is called ray of light. Okay, a straight thin line, remember it is a straight thin beam of light that is from a source to an object is called a ray of light. Then comes the beam of light. Beam of light is a bunch of light that travels in a given direction. Okay, so bunch of light that travels in a given direction is called a beam of light.
Obstacle as a hindrance in a path, or if you meet some big rock.
that is a hindrance. So obstacle is an object which comes in the path of light is called obstacle. Okay, an object which comes in the path of light. Suppose a light is following in such a direction and in between an obstacle comes which stops the light to go in. So that object is called as an obstacle. Okay, so an object which comes in the part of the light ke path pe is called obstacle. Okay, if light is following like this, suppose in between and something comes which stops further the light to go. Okay, next we will see what is rectilinear propagation. Okay, so if we talk about rectilinear propagation, light travels in a straight line and this is called rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, this is a property of a light that it travels in a straight line. Next we will see a pinhole camera in which we will conclude that light travels in a straight line. So rectilinear propagation is light travels in a straight line this is called rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, so we have seen some few terms which is very important in light and it is also important from the examination point of view, because sometimes one mark questions comes that what is a beam of light, what is a ray of light, or what is an obstacle, or what is a rectilinear propagation. So an obstacle is an object which comes in the path of light. Okay, usko hum kya bolenge, obstacle. Then rectilinear propagation, light travels in a straight line. This is a feature of a light that light always travels in a straight line. And this feature of a light is called as rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, so next we are going to see the pinhole camera. So what is a pinhole camera and what is its properties, how we can make pinhole camera and what is a natural pinhole camera, all these will be covered today. Okay, so firstly pinhole camera. Okay, so pinhole camera is, you can say, is a toy device that is used to see that light travels in a straight. Okay, so it's a toy device used to see that light travels in a straight line. Toy device that we can create by ourselves, just we need few things and we can make a pinhole camera. So our toy device which is used to see that light travels in a straight line. Okay, so a toy device which is used to see that light travels in a straight line is a pinhole camera. Now we will see some of the properties or some of the features of a pinhole camera. The first thing is that a pinhole camera the image that is formed by a pinhole camera, we know that any camera, since it is a camera, it is going to make some image. It is going to form some image. We have got camera in our phone. What we do? We click some images. We have got a normal camera. What is the purpose of a camera? To click a image. So similarly, this pinhole camera is also going to click some image, or it is going to form some image. So the image formed by this pinhole camera is colored. Okay? The image that is going to be formed by this pinhole camera is colored. The image that is formed by the pinhole camera is inverted. Okay? And the image that is formed by the pinhole camera is smaller in size. If the object is big, but it makes a smaller image. Okay? So these are some of the features of a pinhole camera. So we have seen three main features of a pinhole camera, that is the image formed by a pinhole camera,
into another with no gap in between them. Okay, so boxes
like this. You can see in the image C, one box is sliding into the other box and there is no gap in between both. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to cut open one side of each box. Okay. So here in the image you can see this front of the box, this has the upper side has been cut. Okay. On the opposite face of the larger box, make a small hole in the middle. So here you can see a small hole is there in the larger box. This is a two box we have to take. So this one is big larger than this. This is a smaller. So a small hole we have made. This black dot you can see, that is a small hole that is to be made on the opposite face of the larger box. Okay. So in a smaller box, what we have to do? We have to cut out from the middle in a square, middle side of about 5 to 6 centimeter. Okay. So see in the image B here. So in the larger box A, we have made a hole. In B, you can see we have made a cut. Okay. So here you can see this is a square cut, and that is about 5 to 6 centimeter. Fine. So in this smaller box, we have to make a cut like this of about 5 to 6 centimeter. Fine. So next, what you have to do is cover this open square in the box with dressing paper. Okay. Translucent screen we have to make. We have, if you will go in my part one especially, then you will get to know that there are three types of images formed, that is three types of objects are there: transparent, translucent and a opaque object. So translucent object is the one that allows the light to pass through it, but not the whole light, partially it allows the light to pass through it. Okay. So cover this open square in the box with tracing paper, and that is a translucent screen. Okay. So you have to cover that square box. As you can see in this figure, this square box is to be covered by a translucent paper, and that translucent paper should be such that it allows partial light to pass through it. Fine. Now what we have to do, we have to slide the smaller box inside the larger one with the hole. Okay. So see in the figure how we are sliding. This is the larger box which is having a slide hole. In this we have to slide this smaller box that is having a square cut on which a translucent paper is being attached. Fine. In such a way that the side with the tracing paper is inside. Okay. So one thing you should be very careful that you have to slide this small box inside the bigger in a way that this cut goes inside. Okay, it should not be on the surface here. It should be the inner portion. Fine. So your pinhole camera is now ready to use. This was only the setup. You can see it is very simple. We have taken two boxes. Box 1 is bigger in size, box 2 is smaller in size. In the box 1 we have made a small hole, in the box 2 which was smaller in size we have made a square cut that is of 5 to 6 cm and we have put a translucent paper on it. Now we have to slide this smaller box in a bigger box in a way that this gap it goes inside. Okay. So your pinhole camera is now ready to use. So now holding the pinhole camera, looking through the open face of the smaller box. Okay. So now you have to hold the pinhole camera and you have to see through the smaller box. What you are going to see that you should use a piece of black cloth to cover your head and the pinhole camera. Okay. So to use the pinhole camera, what you have to do? Suppose you are viewing from here, you need to take a black cloth from which you are going to cover this pinhole camera also. If you are sitting here, you have to cover your head also. And from here, this square, you have to look. Fine? So, now try to look at the some distance object like a tree, a building through the pinhole camera. Now from this pinhole camera, you have to see some distance object that can be a tree or a building. Okay, so make sure that the object you wish to look at through your pinhole camera are in bright sunshine. Okay, it should not be in dark, it should be in a bright sunshine when there is a sun. Then sunny time you have to look at. If you are going to look in the night, you cannot see. If there will be no light, you cannot see. Okay, so move the smaller box forward or backward. Okay, so what you have to do, this is smaller box, you can move forward means this side, or backward means this side. Okay, so this side or this side, you have to move it for just for the adjustment. Okay, so move the smaller box forward or backward till you get a picture on the tracing paper pasted on the other end. Okay, so you keep on moving this box and you will see that you will get a picture on this tracing paper that you have kept. So when that image will be formed, a picture will be formed in this tracing paper that is going to give you the image. Okay, so till you are not getting the image, you need to keep it forward and backward. You need to move it forward and backward. So you can look through pinhole camera at the vehicles and people moving on the road in a bright sunlight. So this pinhole camera lets you to see people differently in different ways. Okay, so you can see any kind of building, any people moving on the road or any vehicles that is going. So this is a very small and a very good setup anybody can make at a home. For this you only just need two cardboards, okay, one bigger in size, the other one smaller in size, in such a way that it gets fitted in the smaller one gets fitted in the bigger one with no space. So this was all about pinhole camera, a sliding pinhole camera. Okay, so you have seen how it is being made and how it works. So what is a natural pinhole camera? If you see in the nature, we have got a natural pinhole camera. So what is that? A very interesting pinhole camera in nature is present. It is what sometimes you must have seen that when you pass under a tree that is covered with lots of leaves. Okay? So those trees which have got a lot number of leaves, you notice that some small patches of sun under it. Okay? Under the tree you will see some small patches of a sun like this. And these images are circular in shape. A circular patches of a sun or a circular image of a sun you can see. And that is acting as a, this gap between the leaf, they act as a pinhole camera. Okay, so that's why they are acting as a pinhole camera. And how many gaps will be there, that many image is going to be formed in a small hole, a small circle form. Okay, so this is going to act as a natural pinhole camera. The gaps of the leaves may be irregular, but the images formed are always circular in shape. Okay, so this is, we have seen that what is the working of a pinhole camera. So we have seen that when two cardboards have been slided and from a gap an image was coming. So in between the gaps between the leaf, this hole is acting as a pinhole camera and the image of different images of sun are being formed and they are circular in shape. Although the shapes of the leaves or the gaps between the leaves, they are irregular. Okay, so this is one of the natural pinhole camera which we see in our nature. Now students, one thing I would like to tell you, that you should never look at the sun directly. Okay, it is harmful, it is not good to eye, and it is extremely harmful to our eyes if we look directly. Okay, so we should either look at the sun by some face if you are using your eyes, or you wear some glasses, or through some medium you should look. Okay, so looking at the sun directly from the eyes is very harmful to our eyes. So we have seen all about pinhole camera. This was about pinhole camera. A natural pinhole camera are the gaps between leaves, they form circular image, form circular image of sun. Okay, so that is acting as a natural pinhole camera. Okay, so the pinhole camera is finished here. Next we will see about mirror. What is a mirror and reflection? And this is the last topic of this chapter, mirror and reflection. So if we talk about mirror is what? Mirror is a smooth shining surface which rebounds the light back in the same or in a different direction is called mirror. Mirror mein kya hota hai ki light is coming and it falls on the shining surface and it is rebounding the light back wapas bhej dega wo light ko ya to same direction mein bhejega ya kisi different direction mein. Okay, so mirror is a smooth shining, or you can say a polished surface or a smooth shining surface, that is a polished surface. Okay, a smooth shining surface which rebounds the light. Okay, it is rebounding the light back, वापस भेज देता है light को, लेकिन किसमें भेजता है? Back in the same direction. It can be in the same direction. Okay, or in different direction. वो light जो वापस जाती है वो same direction में भी जा सकती है और different directions में भी जा सकती है. Okay, or in different directions. So this is called a mirror. A smooth shining surface, or you can say a polished surface which rebounds the light back into the same direction or in a different direction. Okay, now we will see the types of mirror. There are three types of mirror basically. The concave mirror, convex mirror and a plane mirror. Okay, so we will discuss the three types of mirror. Only introduction is there in your syllabus, so we are not going to study in detail. So the plane mirror is the image form is of the same size. In case of plane mirror, image form is of the same size. We shall be seeing how image is being formed in the plane mirror. Image form is of same size. Okay, the regular mirror that we are using at our home is a plane mirror. Then we will, concave mirror is the reflecting surface in bent in, and the convex mirror is the reflecting surface is bulged out. Okay, so that diagram I will be showing you. So in a concave mirror, okay, the reflecting surface is bulged in. So this is a concave mirror where you can see the reflective surface is bulged in. Okay, and if we talk about convex mirror, in the convex mirror you can see that the reflecting surface is here, it is bulged out. Okay, so this is about the types of mirror. Only you have to know that a plane mirror, concave and convex, three types of mirrors are there. Very little introduction about the reflection of light is there in this class. In class 8 you will study in detail about the reflection and light. So if you see what is reflection of light, okay, so if you talk about reflection of light, when a ray of light falls on a smooth and polished surface. Okay, suppose it is a smooth and polished surface there in which a ray of light is falling down. Okay, so what is going to happen? It returns back in the same medium. So this light is going to return back in the same medium. So this light which is falling is called incident ray. Okay, and the one that is going to be reflected back is refracted ray. Okay, we will not go in detail because in your syllabus it is not in detail, but this thing you should know just. So if you make a line here, this beam of light that is falling on the smooth and polished surface is an incident ray, and the one that is reflected back is a refracted ray. This is angle I, that is the incident angle of incidence, and this is R, that is angle of refraction. Okay, need not to go in detail. So refraction of light is when a ray of light falls on a polished and a smooth surface. Okay, the light returns back in the same medium. So this is called as reflection of light, or you can say this is simply a reflection. When a ray of light falls on a polished and a smooth surface, this ray of light is falling on a polished and a smooth surface, the light returns back in the same medium. This light is returning back in the same medium. The one that is falling is incident ray, the one that is reflected back is a refracted ray. This is making angle I and this is making angle R. Okay, so this was reflection of light. Now in a few things about plane mirror is there in this syllabus and nothing else. Virtual means the light rays do not actually come from the image. It is a virtual image, not a real image. Okay? It's a virtual image means the light ray is not actually coming from the image, but it seems that it is coming from the image. Okay? So the image is virtual. Second thing is that the image that is being formed by the plane mirror is erect. What does erect mean? Erect image is formed by a plane mirror. It means that always the upper portion will remain up and the down is down. If you look yourself in a mirror, your head is always up. If you are standing in front of a mirror, your leg is always down. It's not like your leg goes up and your head goes down. Whereas when we have seen a pinhole camera, the image was not erect. Okay? We have seen that the image has been not erect. The image has gone upside down. Okay? So virtual image is there means the light rays do not actually come from the image, but it seems that light rays are coming from the image. Okay, next, the image is erect means if a person is standing like this, suppose here is a person, he is standing like this, His image will be also like this. Okay? Then the image form is of the same distance as that of the object. If suppose you can see here, image and object both are of the same distance. Okay? So image form is of the same size as the object. Okay? So virtual, AirWrap, and of the same size. In pinhole camera we have seen that the image is smaller in size. Okay? Next, if you see the property, the image is at the same distance behind the mirror as the object is in front of the mirror. If this is a mirror and you are standing here, the image form will be also same. ओके अगर आप इतने दूर पे खड़े हैं मिरर के इतने फ्रंट में खड़े हैं तो आपकी इमेज भी इतने ही पीछे फॉर्म होगी. ओके सो द इमेज फॉर्म इज एट द सेम डिस्टेंस बिहाइंड द मिरर Thank you.